Ladies and gentlemen, the American jury and Bulldog Nation, today in history, in 1765, November 1st, Parliament passed the Stamp Act. The Stamp Act got the American patriots on this side of the ocean revved up pretty good. Man, they charged tax on a stamp for anything, even newspapers. Anyway, always remember that this country was founded upon a bunch of rebels who were mad about taxes and representation and everything else. Never, ever forget that. Of course, those in our government have forgotten that. Biden is now at 42% approval rating. He's sinking faster than a lead boat in the middle of water with a 2-ton anchor tied to it being pulled down by a giant squid. I mean, this guy is sinking. Biden is going to the G20. You know, can you imagine the clown, what this clown does over there at the G20? The things that he says, the things he's worried about. Everything's collapsing here at home. Meanwhile, along those lines, at Glasgow, he's got sending apparently all kinds of people in his cabinet for the climate accord. John Kerry and company and all of them, climate accord. Meanwhile, down in Atlanta, Trump showed up, I think it was Saturday night for the baseball game. Atlanta's up 3-2 in the World Series. And he and Melania did the tomahawk. You know what? The Braves, the Atlanta Braves, are obviously staying a little bit stronger than those Cleveland Indians. But good for Trump doing the tomahawk. Then we have Joe Biden meeting with the Pope. He got all emotional about it. He said the Pope said it was okay if he takes communion or not. You know, ladies and gentlemen, the American jury and Bulldog Nation, Joe Biden is a baby-killing president. He was a baby-killing senator. The idea that he gets to meet with the Pope and the Pope says everything's okay, either A, it's a bunch of bullshit, or the Pope has got some problems. Of course, we all know this Pope does have some problems with some of the things that comes out of his mouth, his policy, so forth and so on. The Wall Street Journal, in fact, I was going to save it, had a whole section this weekend about what to do about social media. Folks, I can sum up everything that needs to be done to get social media back to where it needs to be. It's called antitrust. I don't know what's happened to our government, beginning with George Bush, 43. Well, Clinton, George Bush, 43, then Obama, then Biden. I mean, is there an antitrust department in the Department of Justice? I don't think that there is. The Washington Post has called critical race theory as phony, and GOP, people like you and me, are thugs. Phony issue. Yeah, it's a phony issue to them because it's working in Virginia. Southwest Airlines pilot, while he was going to land, chanted, "Let's go, Brandon," to the delight of everybody. Apparently, Southwest Airlines has had to apologize. Isn't it great that there's a code, and I'm going to talk about it a little bit more here in a second. Let's go, Brandon. It's a wonderful code. Georgia-Florida game. They broke out and not so modest and nice. They did the real thing with Joe Biden. The Inquirer had a story titled, "How Let's Go, Brandon Became Code Phrase Used as Vulgar Chant Towards Biden." Well, you know what? I think it was October 2nd. When that happened, when an NBC reporter tried to change the Biden to "Let's go, Brandon." An NBC reporter caused the whole thing. It wasn't the GOP. It wasn't anybody else. It was an NBC reporter. Lincoln Project scum. These guys had five or six guys dressed up with their little tiki torches, khaki pants, as some kind of white symbol, you know, trying to make the Virginia Republican candidate for governor look like a racist. It was all a set-up scam. You know, Terry McAuliffe is a disgrace. Speaking of that, more registered voters than not now oppose Black Lives Matter. It's running its course, isn't it? Speaking of the Virginia governor race, which is tomorrow, clearly McAuliffe is going to lose. But you know the thing that cracked me up? Terry McAuliffe is such a scumbag. You know, he was Bill Clinton's lawyers, him and Hillary. He will say and do anything. Today I saw where he announced that they need more diversified teachers in Virginia. You know, just saying it. Oh, and now it's not about Trump. The race isn't about Trump the day before the election. I hope he just doesn't lose. I hope he loses big. Colin Kaepernick said the NFL Combine is like slave owners buying slaves. You know, there's a lot of white people that go through the Combine too. Lots of white. It's not just black. It's not less. And you know what? They aren't slaves. They make millions and millions and millions of dollars playing football, Colin Kaepernick. Man, by the way, this is all in a Netflix documentary. I won't be watching. Tuesday's the Ohio elections. We all know what's going to happen there. Aftab Pureball is going to be your new mayor. Ugh. By the way, the Cincinnati City Council, it's always a freaking train wreck. It doesn't matter who's elected. Adam Kissinger from Illinois, one of those Republicans who were against Trump, is not running for re-election. That's two down. Ohio ID voter BS. I actually saved this, folks. To vote in Ohio, photo ID, Ohio driver's license, government photo ID, concealed weapon document, acceptable documents, utility bill, bank statement, government check, payroll check, government document. Like military ID, like those can't be fraudulently used. Do you believe you can show up with a bank statement, a utility bill, and claim you're that person? That's unfreaking believable. Sorry, folks. Ohio's not so clean in their voting either. More stuff. The Atlanta Braves, can't make this up. CNN did a story about how the Atlanta Braves might be doing well in the World Series right now. But they really have to come to grips with the city of Atlanta and what they've done and blah, 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 blah. I mean, unbelievable. The Bengals call. I don't cover sports, but I want to tell you right now. That flag that was thrown against Hilton, against the Bengals, when they had him stopped and it was going to be fourth down, just proves referees get – and they destroy sports. You don't think referees don't influence the outcome of the games? There's not gambling going on. That call right there is exhibit freaking A. Jason Williams of the Inquirer. I like making fun of this guy because he did this story yesterday about, oh, if you don't vote, blah, blah. You know, he apologized a while back to Trump voters, but then he took another swipe at him yesterday. He acts like, you know, you can vote a certain way and then it's okay. You get more of all of this. Hey, Jason Williams, what would happen to the city of Cincinnati if Trump voters elected Trump candidates to Cincinnati City Council? It'd be a hell of a lot better city. J.D. Vance. I love these ads where they're hitting J.D. Vance, candidate for United States Senate in Ohio, about all the things he said about Trump. He was the anti-Trump, said he's going to hold his nose and vote for Hillary Clinton, on and on and on. And now he acts like he's Mr. Republican. J.D. Vance. He might be a Republican, but he ain't a Trump Republican. Gates and Bezos met on their big yacht, flown in, $2 million a day yacht or something like that, that old Bill Gates has for his birthday. Think of all the super yachts and all the climate issues that they cause. The U.S. Supreme Court, I commented this on the other show, you know, it's just disgraceful. The U.S. Supreme Court, the people that sit on that court, you know, it is turned into a swamp just like anything else, and it's sad. ISIS, threats in ISIS in Virginia malls. We didn't have that back during the Trump years, did we? Nope. The Brent Spence Bridge is going to open. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm just going to close with that. This is the Bulldog. Every dog has their day. Have a great day.